Hello, my friends, and welcome to another video. My name is Devlin Peck, and I help instructional designers learn new skills and land opportunities, which is why today we are going to take a look at website builders, because one of the first considerations that you're probably going to make when building your portfolio website, which you definitely should do if you're trying to land ID opportunities, is deciding which website builder to use. So after helping a lot of IDs and exploring a lot of different builders, we've kind of narrowed it down to three main website builders that we recommend. So let's dive right in. So the first one is Squarespace, and you've probably heard of this. It's kind of like a big competitor to Wix. It's the best option for getting something online quickly that still looks polished and professional. So the people that I work with in my bootcamp, for example, a lot of them are trying to land their first ID job and do it on a bit of a quick timeline. They don't want to spend like 6 months to a year just working on a website. So Squarespace is like the best option in those cases. And if you explore the showcase at devlinpeck.com/showcase and see all the portfolios there, probably around half of them or a little under half of them are built with Squarespace. So it has really good templates that are already streamlined and user-friendly. So you don't have to like start from scratch. You can start from a template that you like. It's relatively easy to use, so there isn't a big learning curve. You can kind of dive right in, and it might be frustrating at times, but there are support documents, there are tutorials, and it's mostly intuitive. Downside is that it can be somewhat pricey, probably on the low end, over $100 a year, up to like multiple hundreds of dollars per year. And then it also may be difficult to customize some things. As you'll see when it comes to these different website builders, the easier they are to use, the less customization options that you get. So that's a trade-off you'll need to decide for yourself. If you are using Squarespace, you may decide, oh yeah, I need a little bit more spacing here, or I need this to be like aligned with this a little bit better. Sometimes you're just not going to get that option. Your best bet is probably working from one of their templates, just because they already, you know, they are mostly designed well and streamlined and aligned and all of that stuff. But if you are trying to build something really custom, you're probably going to wind up getting frustrated with Squarespace. And I do want to show you, this is the Squarespace editor. So I want to give you an idea of what all of these editors look like, as well as an example of site built with each of these tools. So obviously it's nice and easy to change text. You see, we can just like type in the text box. And this is a template, by the way. This is one of the templates that you can start with. You know, you have all of your general text editing tools here, just like you would in like a word processor. You can click on the different sections to edit them. You'll have little menus like this to kind of easily add logos, change out site titles. You see, you're basically editing it by doing changes directly on the screen or making changes in little pop-up menus like this that are generally pretty self-explanatory. So you can change the size of that section of this section here. So fairly self-explanatory. I also want to show you this. So if you want to add a section, you can just click on this and you have tons of options. So it's kind of like if you've ever used Articulate Rise, they give you a lot of different options to work with. If you see something you like if we want to add a section like this, if we're like, maybe we want a nice like full screen section like this, we can just click on it and then we can swap out the content. We can change out the images as we want, and it makes a carousel for us nice and easy just like that. So pretty easy, pretty templated, and fairly customizable. So that one is Squarespace. Again, this is the most common one that we see people use, but and let me show you a quick example too. Again, most of the portfolios on the showcase are built with Squarespace, but we'll just take a quick look at Sean's website. He started with one of the Squarespace templates and it looks good. Like the site looks good. It's nice and simple. We can explore this project. We see this nice full screen section at the top. But yeah, nice and simple, nothing super fancy, but this helped Sean get multiple offers and a really good job that he likes. And it's a really nice, well-designed one project portfolio that didn't take him like months to develop. I think he got this online in like a week and a half, if that. So could definitely move quickly with Squarespace. Okay, next up we have Google Sites. You've probably come across this one. The biggest benefit is probably that it's free. So hosting the website is completely free, as well as using the editor. So if you're on a budget and you want to get something online quickly, Google Sites is a really good option. It's pretty easy to use, but because it's even easier to use than Squarespace, you're going to have even less customization options. So if you want to build something really custom, Google Sites is not the platform for you, but you can make some really, really impressive, good-looking websites with this tool, and we will look at one. So I'm going to hop back over to sharing my screen. Here is what the Google Sites editor looks like. You can probably tell it's quite similar to Squarespace, right? We can just like type in here and it changes the text. We have this nice text editor here. We can swap out images as we want. You see, we can replace the image there, and we can add sections over here on the right. So notice we can insert different content blocks, swap an image, add some text. We can add these kind of like, you know, multiple, like a rows basically of content. And you can tell there are a lot of different options here. You can embed YouTube videos just by clicking that. So nice and easy, kind of what you see is what you get. You can add new sections as you go. One of my favorite Google sites is Steve. I worked with him on this one in the bootcamp, but this is all built with Google Sites completely free. This doesn't cost Steve anything per year to host or to make changes to. So really good. Obviously, he used some really nice like imagery here. His copy, if you take the time to read it, is really good. I actually did a portfolio review of Steve's site a while back, so you could check that out if you'd like. But yeah, this is all built with Google Sites. Yeah, Google Sites buttons, you don't have a ton of customization options. So there are some things that you may be like, oh, I wish I could change this. And it's just like, there's really no good way to actually do so. But you definitely can create a professional, effective portfolio website with Google Sites. It just may not be as custom as some of the other options. All right, so moving right along, the last one that we often recommended, this is what I use for my website. It is Webflow. So this one offers full customization. So if you do want to build something really custom without having to like code it from scratch, Webflow is definitely the tool for you. It does naturally have a steeper learning curve, right? It is a little bit more difficult to use. You are basically like modifying the code visually. So it's not really like, oh, just add this section. You actually have to change the numbers associated with like the padding and the position and the margins. So it is a little bit more difficult, but they do have a really good like Webflow University with a ton of free tutorials and videos, really in-depth, really actually engaging and entertaining. It's actually good going through the Webflow University videos just to kind of see examples of like good instructional design and how engaging you can make just video content. So check it out, Webflow University. You will definitely learn web development principles while using this tool if you don't know them already. So that could be a pro or a con if you're like on a really fast timeline. But you will definitely learn about web dev while using this. It also can be pricey, a couple $100 a year basically. And it's only up from there if you wind up wanting to like build out a content management system and do some more complex things down the line. But it's a really, really good tool to grow with. So what we see, like what a common approach that people use is if they need to land a role ASAP, they'll use a tool like Squarespace just to get something online, show off their flagship project and get their foot in the door. And then as they're trying to kind of build their presence, build something a little bit more custom, they will often switch to Webflow just because it is more custom. And because it does give you a lot more opportunity to grow and to manage content and all of that stuff. So this is what the Webflow editor looks like. At first glance, it might seem pretty similar to the others, right? We can just click in there and edit text, but that's pretty much where the similarities end. So notice when we move our mouse around, we see these different boxes where they're actually like editing text sections within like divs, within containers, within sections. And all of these things can have different properties. Like notice the margin over here. If I change the left margin to like 60, see it moves over like this whole section. So that's how you edit these different things. If we want to edit the text, we click on the text box we want to change the text for, we scroll down and we actually change the text size and the line height. And then also we can like add classes and stuff. So we're actually modifying the HTML, the CSS, and in some cases the JavaScript, because you can add like animations and interactions to these sites as well. It can get quite custom as you'd want it to actually. And another really cool part about Webflow is you get like really fine control over each of the different breakpoints. So Whereas something like Squarespace, maybe you can change how it looks on desktop and mobile. But notice on Webflow, you can change like how it looks on a tablet, how it looks on a mobile landscape view, and how it looks on a mobile portrait view. And you can also work your way up to like larger breakpoints as well. So I'm not going to get too deep into it, but much more fine-tooth control, but you just have to edit the actual HTML and CSS for these different elements using this panel on the right to modify things. It's not really like a drag and drop kind of editor. You will need to know what you're doing to some degree, or you will get very frustrated with this tool very quickly. And a quick example, I recorded a portfolio review of Kristen's site recently, but this was built with Webflow. You could see, she's incorporating some nice animations. It may look kind of like the other ones at first glance. Like, you can build a site like this with Squarespace, for example, but Kristen had much more control over the exact spacing, the exact placement, the exact animations, all of the above with Webflow. And they also do have templates. Like, this is just a template I started with here. So yeah, you've got templates. So you do have some things that can help speed up your development with Webflow, but you will just have much more customization in the long run. So these are the three tools we've been recommending in the bootcamp program and that most of the people I work with use. There are other options like WordPress. Wix is an alternative for Squarespace. So if you already have a website builder you like, of course, use whatever you're most comfortable with. Let me know which one of these you think you will wind up going with. And if you do want my help building your portfolio, building your flagship project, and landing your top choice opportunities, feel free to check out the ID Bootcamp, which you can do at idbootcamp.com. So I will see you there. I'll see you in the next video. And I'll also link some more portfolio videos in the description if you'd like some extra help here on YouTube. So I'll talk to you soon, and I'll see you in the next one.